Hydrologists are concerned with the processes that control how water is distributed among the different parts of the water cycle, like rainfall, groundwater, and water in streams. My name is Daniella Rempe, and I'm a hydrology professor at UT. I focus on forests and mountainous environments. I received my bachelor's from UT in geosystems engineering and hydrogeology, then I went on to UC Berkeley for a master's in environmental engineering and a PhD in geology. Rainfall that enters the ground can either evaporate or get sucked up by plants and return to the atmosphere, or it can penetrate deep into the ground and end up in a groundwater reservoir or take a long path to a stream or lake at some later time. Because it's hard to see what happens to water once it enters the ground, especially in mountainous areas that are hard to access and comprised of a host of different rock types, hydrologists use a variety of tools to infer the flow paths that water takes. We, like many earth scientists, bring together skills in chemistry, physics, and even biology to track water in the ground and understand how mountains store and release our fresh water. For example, we look at the isotopes of hydrogen and oxygen in trees or in streams to identify how much water has evaporated. In my research group in particular, we use techniques not too different from the ones you'll see at the doctor's office, like x-rays and MRIs, to directly image the water in the ground. My research group uses innovative ways to look inside mountains to tie the properties of the soil and the rock and how spongy they are to how water moves through a mountain. We try to figure out how much water is used to support our forests and how much hangs around later to be discharged to our river networks and support our aquatic ecosystems. Because the sponginess of a rock is related to how weathered it is, we take rocks back to our lab to study the chemical and physical processes that attack the rock and convert it into porous and permeable material that can pass water through it from the timescale of a storm to centuries or millennia. Fresh water is essential to life. To predict how water availability and water quality might change due to things like droughts or floods or human activities like logging or development, hydrologists like me are working to understand how the subsurface stores and releases water. I focus on mountainous areas because they're an important freshwater supply.
My name is Alison. I worked in conservation through AmeriCorps St. Louis for a year after college and realized that I was really interested in the science behind the natural landscapes that we were managing. We worked in many parts of Missouri and Montana where the hydrology was both interesting and important to the local community. This brought me to the University of Texas at Austin, where I'm now pursuing a PhD within the water, climate, and environment theme. My research focuses on carbon and water cycling in what scientists are calling the critical zone, the area that includes everything from the tree canopy to groundwater that is critical to sustaining life. In particular, I look at the region between the surface of the soil to groundwater, or the unsaturated zone. The unsaturated zone contains solids like soil or rock, water, and gases. This is also known as the zone of aeration because it contains oxygen, which is important for respiration in plant roots and microorganisms. Under these aerobic conditions, oxygen is used to break down organic carbon and produces carbon dioxide, an important compound for global climate. If, how, and when organic carbon is consumed in this region is important for groundwater quality, vegetation, global carbon cycling, and even things that occur on longer timescales like the formation of mountains and rivers. And water plays a really key role in all of this in ways that we still don't fully understand. Critical zone science brings together experts from hydrology, chemistry, biology, and many other disciplines in order to answer questions on many different scales of time and space. Through my graduate studies, I've been able to pursue a summer internship with the National Park Service in Yellowstone National Park, take trips to my field site at the Eel River Critical Zone Observatory, and take classes that explore the hydrology of places like Valles Caldera in New Mexico. Being a field hydrologist that focuses on water chemistry is very exciting and involves many adventures. The cool thing about hydrology is that there are career options across a wide range of educational backgrounds and levels of expertise.
Hydrologists do a diverse number of things, from sampling water in streams in remote locations to running sophisticated computer models of the climate.
For example, there are jobs in taking care of contaminants in our water and also jobs in municipal water resources.
So if you're interested in water resources, there are a lot of options in the field of hydrology.